Hello students, welcome back to classes on computer organization. Let us see the register transfer here. So we are talking about the module 5, so fifth module concept. So that is basic processing unit. Now let us see how to mention the register in and register out. What is register in? If any register is taking the data as input, then it is called as register in. If any data is pro any register is sending the data, I mean register is used for some used by someone for accessing data accessing purpose, then it is called, it is to be marked as register out. In general, let us denote the register as RI, because it can be R is a general purpose register, and I represents the general format, general ID. It can be ranges from 0 to n minus 1. Okay, usually 16 registers will be there, right, in 16 bit bits. So R0 to R15, it can be any number. So in general, marked as I. RI, which has got two switches. Okay. Two switches, one is input switch and other one is output switch. So RI in, if input switch is activated, you can see the bidirectional arrow in the sense, say RI is taking the input from internal processor bus via the switch. If the switch is activated, then RI can access the data from the internal processor bus, isn't it? What is a switch? Switch establishes the circuit, isn't it? There are two states for the switch, open and closed. If the switch is closed, say circuit is closed means current flows, right, from internal processor bus to RI. If RI in switch is activated, if RI out switch is activated, then what will happen? If RI out switch is activated, then data can be sent on to the internal processor bus. Okay, so there are two states, one is input state, other one is the output state. Very general scenario, right? Input state as well as the output state. So in case of input state, RI in is activated, if RI in is activated, then what will happen? The circuit will be closed and internal processor bus data can be placed onto the register RI. Okay, at the same time, if RI out is closed, I mean if RI out is activated, then what will happen? Data from RI will be placed onto the internal processor bus. That's it. Okay, the same is applicable for register Z as well. Y is not having another switch, say Y out, because by default the content from Y is transferred onto the multiplexer. If Y in is activated, then data from internal processor bus will be copied onto register Y. Okay, the same is applicable for register Z as well. So input and output gating, it is called as input and output gating. Very simple to understand. There is an input gate and there is an output gate. Say the gates are nothing but switches. Okay, if you activate a particular switch, necessary action will be taken. You can activate either input switch or output switch as per your requirement. If input switch is activated, please remember, register will take input from bus. If output switch is activated, register will give the output onto the bus. The register will place the data, in other words, onto the bus. Okay, the same explanation is given here. Please try to understand this. Please go through it. What will happen when RI in is activated and RI out is activated is explained here. Okay,